Yeah, I Also, lots of people asking for tools to help me.
Yeah.
All right, come on, I think that you're not stuck here. Here's the coffee.
Good morning and welcome. Welcome to the service of celebration and thanksgiving for the life and witness of our beloved Hugo. Rest eternal, our grand and dream, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon you. May your souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace and rise in glory. I'm told I can take off my mask so that you can sound more. Stand, please. Faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our beloved brother Hugo for burial. Our brother Hugo was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that you'll raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, remember before you today our brother Hugo. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and love as a companion and a pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth. And until by your call we are united with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. For those who have the liturgy, page 362. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die.
Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me.
I am sure that neither death nor life, no angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, no heights, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
We brought nothing into the world and we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting. Sing the hymn, to God be the glory. To God be the glory, great things he has done. So loved he the world that
he gave us his son.
And open the life gate that all may go in. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Who come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he has done. The purchase of blood to every believer, the promise of God, the vilest offender who truly believes, the moment from Jesus the pardon receives. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the young hear his voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice who come to the Father through Jesus the Son,
come give him the glory. Great things he has done.
Great things he has taught us.
Great things he has done.
And great all rejoicing through Jesus the Son. But purer and higher and greater
will be.
Oh, wonder or transport when Jesus we see. Praise the Lord,
praise the Lord.
Let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord,
praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice.
Oh, come to the Father through Jesus
the Son.
And give him the glory, great things he hath done. Let us pray. Almighty God, remember before you today your servant Hugo. And we pray that having opened to him the gates of a larger life, you will receive him more and more into your joyful service. That with all who have served you in the past, he may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, has given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of the saints and the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection and the eternal life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We sit for the ministry of the Holy.
Reading from the Word of God written in the book of Isaiah, chapter 25, verses 6 to 9. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wines strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is passed over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. And the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Psalm 23 to the tune of Kriman. Psalm 23 to the tune of Kriman. The Lord is my shepherd,
I not want. He makes me down to lie in pastures green.
We know. John chapter 14, verses 1 to 6. John 14, 1 to 6. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If you do not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I'm going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? And Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of Christ. I speak to you this morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I will begin by extending my heartfelt sympathy to his wife and his offspring, his friends and family. On behalf of my wife and I, where do I begin this morning? As we celebrate and give God thanks for a life that has touched us in so many different ways. I'm trying to remember, it's over 45 years. You know, you make true friends in life, and Hugo is one. Last 45 years that we have, since we met, and we've been friends from that day. And we always have something in common to talk about, especially our hunting expedition. And so this reminds me of the first time I took himself and Al to hunt. And I know it's a day, so forth. And every encounter, there's something different we learn about ourselves as friends. We were more than friends, we were brothers. And so much so, in the end, we said, well, let's try to meet at least once a month as we grieve and as we celebrate life as God has allotted to us. So this morning's service, a celebration and thanksgiving for many reasons, but chiefly to thank God for a life that has touched us in so many different ways. You see, God called and used. God calls us just as He called His Son Jesus Christ and used us to the furtherance of His kingdom, to assist God in establishing His kingdom here on earth. Because Hugo always talk about love, and I never heard him speak differently or harshly about any person. I never heard him cry or moan. It's always, you know, talking about the goodness in us, his experience and how he shared his experience with others and how others shared his experience. His friends, they record many times and they exploit and they challenges they have overcome. And so many of the scripture passages, most of the scripture passages we have heard this morning would have impacted on his life. So that he shared that silently assisting God through his own little way of establishing his kingdom here on earth, through the encounters, through his he has activities to his work. I remember, and I must say this, that many years ago, my father was suffering. And by chance, I mentioned it to him. I said, come, bring him a Monday morning. He was looking at the lab then. Around that place, around the Savannah.
Carrot.
And at the end of the examination and the procedure they performed, he lived until he's 92. So in Thanksgiving, we remember, and as we remember, we praise God for his goodness. And this is why a passage from John Gospel is so fitting this morning, because of the question asked by Thomas, where you are going, you do not know the way. Jesus responds, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And that is, for me, impacted the whole life. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And we strive to love like Jesus, and he strives to love like Jesus. So that others may come. And we are this morning glorifying God and thanking him for his life. And work is a witness. And so Hugo set the example. Just as Christ set the example. You will set the example so that all of us can follow. God is calling us from where we are in relationship with him. That's what he says. How we express that relationship with God, with one to one another. Too many of us are waiting for thunderbolt and lightning. And then we want to say, serving God. But God is calling us every day to his service. We have to take time off to respond. And COVID has given us and called us to rethink and show a different way, or show different ways, pulling out of us the best of God into calling to his service. So that as we celebrate, let us be mindful of our relationship with God. Is it good? A few words. Rest eternal our grand country, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon you. May his souls and the souls of all the faithful departed to the mercy of God rest in peace and rise in glory.
You stand now and read the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. Crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Oh, brother Hugo, let us pray to the Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and I am life. Our response will be, hear us, Lord. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Hugo, and dry the tears of those who weep.
Hear us, Lord.
You went to the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow.
Hear us, Lord.
You raised the dead to life. Raise our brother Hugo to eternal life.
Hear us, Lord.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother Hugo to the joys of heaven.
Hear us, Lord.
Our brother Hugo was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give him fellowship with all your saints.
Yes, Lord.
Hugo was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom.
Yes, Lord.
Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our brother Hugo. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope.
When peace like the river. When peace like the river.
When peace like the river, a gentle highway. When sorrows like the billows roll, whatever.
My soul, it is well, it is well with my soul, with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul. Though Satan should buffet,
though trials should come, let me.
Of my father probably will take too long for the morning session that we have. But we know, our family knows, that those of you sitting here, and the most of you who are viewing it remotely, that he touched your lives in some form or fashion, whether in passing or whether substantially. And what we'd like you to do, if possible, is to hold on to a memory that is important to you of Hugo Francis Murchison Reed and bring it before. So whether you were with him as a good boy in Canaan, running past the copper, at full speed to avoid the jumbie, or whether you were with him in his early years of teaching at St. John's, or in England, where he started his scientific career, or you joined him on his many jaunts across the world, delivering scientific papers on streptococcal infections and rheumatic fever. Whether or not you were in church with him in the choir, whether or not he offered you kind words, advice, encouragement as you journeyed along your path, we ask that you find a memory and hold on to it. And if he got you angry for any particular reason, that's okay too, because you probably would have learned something about him and yourself that day. So once you have that memory, I would ask that you join my family with a round of applause to celebrate the life of Hugo Francis Majesty Brunier. He had a great life. And I just want to let you all know that just as he probably touched your lives, I can assure you that you touched and enriched his, and in doing so, you touched and enriched ours. So thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of the day.
I just want to share something that only Hugo knew, and only that one song that he knew. And I don't know how much I will get out of it, but this is what he sang, and the only words that he knew. The autumn leaves drift by my window. The autumn leaves of red and gold. I see your lips, those summer kisses. The sunburned times we used to know. Since you went away, the days grow long, and soon I'll have winter's song. But I miss you most of all. I die when autumn leaves start to fall. He sang that at every pub he went to, all over the world. Thank you very much.
Stand and sing the hymn, Lead Kindly Life. Lead Kindly Life.
Lead kindly light amid the encircling gloom. Lead thou me on. The night is dark and I am far from home. Lead thou me on. Keep thou my feet. I do not ask to see the distant scene. One step enough for me. So long my path. Bless me, show
blooms and your face is a smile, which I have loved long since and lost a while. I was not envious, nor pray that thou should lead me on. I loved to choose and see my path, but now lead thou me on. I loved a garish day, in spite of fears, pride ruled my will. Remember not past years.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints. Their sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind. And we are mortal, formed of the earth, and the earth shall be retained. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, hallelujah, hallelujah. Rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints.
Where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing,
but life everlasting.
Let us commend our brother Hugo to the mercy of God, our maker and defender. Deliver your servant, sovereign Lord Hugo, from all evil, and set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitation, wherewith the Father and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God forever and ever. Amen. In short, certain hope, into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Hugo. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in the light.
Life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, O Lord? who are justly angered by our sins. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Father, deliver us from the pains of the demon.
We pray as our Savior has taught us to say, our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come.
As we forgive those who sin against us, save us from the time of
trouble.
Ensure uncertain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our brother Hugo, and we commit his body to the element. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. And we beseech you in infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this our brother Hugo and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Grant, O Lord, to all our bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in no other name but Christ's name. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. And let light perpetual shine upon him. May his souls and the souls of all the faithful departed rest in peace and rise in glory. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord lift up his countenance upon him and be gracious to him and give him peace. Hallelujah, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power. Both this we ask in honor of thee, but Christ's name. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful depart into the mercy of God. Rest in peace. Right. You sing the last hymn, Up From Grace.
Yes, this chorus, I imagine. Does it chorus, Up From Grace? Up from the grave you rose, where the mountain triumph o'er the stones. Here was a victor from the dark dawn, and he reigns forever where the saints to reign. Here arose, hallelujah, Christ arose. You can sing that again. From the grave he arose, where the mighty triumph o'er his home.
Straight to the commission.
Yes. Yes.
well. Take care.
You breathe your life.
My own eyes have seen the salvation of the light of all. I'd like to reveal to the nation the glory of your people, Israel, glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, and now and ever shall be. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of born of the Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, lost in. So we can sing. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. This is my Savior all the day long. Own assurance, comfort, let's sing the first two verses of what a friend we have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus. All those sins and grief to bear, what a privilege to have. Everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace you often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because you do not carry. Everything to God. Have we trials and temptation? Is there trouble then? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful? Who will all also bear? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord, and let life perpetual shine upon him. May his souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace and rise in glory. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all this time and always. Amen. Do enjoy.